kinetic theory of gases. This kinetic theory of gases was first proposed by Bernoulli. Then it was developed by Maxwell, Boltzmann, Clausius, and others. So the important postulates of kinetic molecular theory of gases are: first one, matter, whether it is in a gaseous state, it is made up of small tiny particles called molecules, or if it is in the case of inert gases, they may call it as an atoms. So these molecules will always be in a random motion in all directions. The matter in gaseous state is made up of or consists of a small tiny particles called molecules. These molecules are in random motion in all directions. While they are moving, they collide with each other and also make collisions with the walls of the container. These molecules are in random motion in all directions. They collide with each other and also make collisions with the walls of the container. These molecular collisions are purely elastic in nature. They neither lose energy nor gain energy due to these collisions. There is a gap, large gap between one molecule to other molecule. These molecular species are far away from each other. That's why the actual volume occupied by these molecules is negligible when compared to the total volume of the gas. For example, here you have certain number of molecules. So the volume of the gas is considered as the volume of this container. So let it be count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let it be 10 molecules. For example, saying cool, I am taking. So if these molecules are close together, these 10 molecules will occupy this volume. This means that this is considered as actual volume of the gas, but here this is the volume of the gas. So this actual volume of the gas is negligible when compared to the volume that was occupied by this gas. This factor is said to be compressibility factor. Compression means decreasing of volume by using external pressure is said to be compression. So the compressibility for the gaseous state is maximum. We cannot compress a solid such an extent. Almost compressibility of solids, almost negligible. Liquids to certain extent they can compress, but not just like these gases. So compressibility of gases is due to the large intermolecular gaps. Next, in gaseous state, there will be no attractive forces or repulsive forces that exist among these gas molecules. They will not attract each other and they will not repel each other. Each gas molecule behaves independently. The presence of one gas molecule will not change its properties like pressure, volume, and all these things due to the presence of another gas. Suppose, for example, here you have taken certain amount of gas in 1 liter container. Keeping the temperature constant and volume constant, if I introduce another gas which is non-reacting gas with this gas, the individual pressure exerted by this gas will not change due to the presence of the newly introduced gas. Of course, due to the introduction of second gas, the total pressure of the gas may increase. But the pressure that was exerted previously by this gas is the same. That means these gas molecules will behave in a similar manner when they are alone or with other gas. That means there will be no attractive or repulsive forces. That means here one condition is there, that gases must be non-reacting gases. If they react with each other, then the composition may change and this that point will not applicable to them for non-reacting gases only, I am telling. Now, the energy of the gases is constantly changes, but average energy is constant. Because they have kinetic energy. Kinetic energy means Ke. Kinetic energy is half mv square. So, the velocity of a single gas molecule is not same all the time. And all gas molecules will not have same velocities. That means each gas molecule velocity is same. If they belong to same gas, their mass may be same. But the kinetic energy of each molecule is vary. That's why we are taking average kinetic energy. Some molecules will have more kinetic energy, some molecules will have less kinetic energy. The kinetic energy of one molecule may decrease and kinetic molecules of another molecule may increase because of these collisions and all these things. But average kinetic energy of a given sample of gas is constant as long as temperature is constant. That means average kinetic energy of the gas molecule, average kinetic energy of the gas molecule is directly proportional to absolute temperature. Is directly proportional to absolute temperature. Ke is directly proportional to capital T. Or Ke is equal to K into T, where K is a constant, proportionality constant. So, these are the important postulates of kinetic molecular theory. Basing on the postulates of these kinetic molecular theory, we can derive a mathematical relationship between pressure, mass, and velocity of the gas molecules. That mathematical relation is known as kinetic gas equation. Kinetic gas equation. According to this equation, PV is equal to 1/3 mn c square. PV is equal to 1/3 mn c square. Here P is the pressure of the gas, V is the volume of the gas, m is mass of a single gas molecule, n is the number of molecules, and c is RMS velocity. RMS velocity. RMS velocity means root mean square velocity. Root mean square velocity. To kinetic gas equation, PV is equal to 1/3 mn c square. Here c we call it as RMS velocity. RMS velocity. RMS velocity means root mean square velocity. Root mean square velocity. What is RMS velocity? Let n number of molecules. What is the necessity first? Let us discuss about the necessity of RMS velocity. Now, the velocity of a molecule is a vector quantity. These molecules are in random motion in all directions. If in this direction the velocity is positive, in opposite direction the velocity will become negative. Another point, all gas molecules are not having same velocity. And velocity of a single gas molecule is not same throughout a given period of time. Constantly, The velocity of a molecule is changing because of the intermolecular collisions or the collision of the molecule with the walls of the container. Constantly, they are changing the direction. So, since it is a vector quantity, all molecules are not having same velocities. If any property is not constant, we'll take an average. Here, to take direct average, there is a problem. Because velocity is a vector quantity, in one direction it is positive, in other direction it is negative, the average sometimes may become zero. To avoid that, this RMS velocity is introduced. So, velocities of the individual molecules are squared, and mean root square of those squared velocities is known as RMS velocity. To understand it clearly, let in a given sample of gas, 50 molecules are with 10 centimeters per second velocity. 40 molecules will have 40%, let it be percent, with 15 centimeters per second velocity. 30% of molecules will have, the 30 molecules will have 12 centimeters per second velocity, and 10 molecules will have 20 centimeters per second velocities. So these are the given sample. These are the velocities and these are the number of molecules. Now to consider the RMS velocity, here 50 molecules, number of molecules, into its velocity square, 10 square, plus 40 molecules into its velocity square, plus 30 molecules into its velocity square, plus 10 molecules into its velocity square by 50 plus 40 plus 30 plus 10 root is known as RMS velocity. So, root means of squares of those velocities are said to be RMS velocity. The main reason to take RMS velocities are two things. One is, all gas molecules are not having same velocities. Velocity of a single gas molecule is not constant throughout its period of time. Because of that, we have to take average of these velocities. By to take average, simple average, there is a difficult, that is vector quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. In one direction if it is positive, in other direction it will be negative. To avoid that, we are taking this RMS velocity. Instead of simple, if n molecules are there, if n number of molecules are there, suppose one molecule will have C1 velocity, other molecule will have C2 velocity, C3 velocity, C4 velocity, and so on with Cn velocity square. So, this will be the RMS velocity. Charles' law, Avogadro's law, Graham's law of diffusion. So now we are going to prove those gas laws with the help of this kinetic gas equation and the postulates of kinetic molecular theory of gases. Now let us discuss those gas laws one by one. First one is Boyle's law. Robert Boyle derived a relationship between properties, that is measurable properties, volume and pressure of a given mass of gas at constant temperature. According to Boyle, at a given temperature, the volume of a given mass of gas is directly proportional to 1 by p, where t and n are constant. That is, temperature and number of moles of gas are constant. Or V is equal to K into 1 by P, or PV is equal to K, that is constant. This is Boyle's law. So we have to prove PV is constant for a given mass of gas at constant temperature. At constant temperature, PV is constant. That is the task that we have to prove with the help of this kinetic gas equation. This kinetic gas equation, PV is equal to 1/3 mn c square, can also be written as PV is equal to 2 by 3 into 1 by 2 mn c square. There is no difference. PV is equal to 1/3 mn c square can be written as PV is equal to 2 by 3 into half mn c square, because 2 cancelled and the remaining thing will be 1/3 mn c square. Now, kinetic energy of a single gas molecule Ke is equal to half mc square. Half mv square is kinetic energy. Here, instead of velocity, we are taking RMS velocity. In place of velocity, we are taking RMS velocity, so it is half mc square. So the kinetic energy of n molecules will be half mn c square. So this half mn c square is kinetic energy of n molecules. According to postulates of kinetic molecular theory of gases, kinetic energy is directly proportional to absolute temperature. Our kinetic energy is equal to K into T. So KE is nothing but KT, but KE is equal to half mn c square. So half mn c square is nothing but K into T. So in place of half mn c square, we can write K into T, where K is a constant and T is absolute temperature. Now we can rewrite this kinetic gas equation as PV is equal to 2 by 3 into K into T. Instead of half mn c square, we are writing K into T, because half mn c square is the kinetic energy of n molecules. Kinetic energy is directly proportional to absolute temperature. So kinetic energy is equal to K into T, where K is a constant. So small k into T is nothing but kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is nothing but half mnc square. That's why PV is equal to 2 by 3 into K into T. Here in this expression, 2 by 3 is a constant, K is a constant. If temperature T is also constant, if you multiply or divide a constant term with a constant term, again you are going to get the constant. So while multiplying three constant terms, the sum PV is equal to constant. PV is equal to constant. PV is equal to constant. When PV is equal to constant? When temperature is constant condition. So when temperature is constant, PV is constant. It is nothing but Boyle's law. So we are proving Boyle's law with the help of kinetic gas equation. Task is proving Chorley's law with the help of kinetic gas equation. First, let us see what is Chorley's law. According to Chorley's law, at constant pressure, the volume of a given mass of gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. At constant pressure, the volume of given mass of gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. Or, that is, P and N constant. P and N, condition is there. It is directly proportional, only P and N are constant. If they are variable, this law does not apply. Now V is equal to K into T, where K is a constant. Proportionality constant. So V is equal to K into T. Or V by T is constant. That means K. V by T is constant K. So V by T is constant when P and N are constant. That is the thing that we have to prove. Now let us come to kinetic gas equation. According to kinetic gas equation, PV is equal to 1/3 mn c square. This kinetic gas equation can rewrite as PV is equal to 2/3 into half mn c square. Half mn c square. Now this half mn c square is nothing but kinetic energy of n molecules. So ke, kinetic energy of n molecules, is equal to half mn c square. According to kinetic molecular theory of gases, kinetic energy ke is directly proportional to T, or ke is equal to K into T, where K is a constant. Now instead of half mn c square, we can take this K into T. Now this kinetic gas equation can again rewrite as PV is equal to 2/3, instead of half mn c square, you can write K into T. K into T. Here 2/3 is a constant, K is constant, temperature is T, capital T is absolute temperature. Thou V is equal to 2/3 into K by P into T. Now if pressure P is constant, K is constant, K by P is also constant, and 2/3 into K by P, the whole thing will become another constant. So instead of all these things, you can write V is equal to constant into T, or V by T is equal to constant. When V by T is constant, when pressure is constant, when pressure is constant, then only V by T is constant. So this is Charles' law. By this way, we are able to prove Charles' law from kinetic gas equation. Next task is to prove Dalton's law of partial pressures. What is Dalton's law of partial pressure? If two non-reacting gases are kept as a mixture, the total pressure exerted by the gases mixture is equal to the sum of the partial pressures of the component gases. Let us explain it. This is one container with volume V. This is another container with same volume V. Here you have gas A and here you have gas B. So the gas molecules, gas A molecules, will exert some pressure. These gas molecules in this container will exert some pressure at a temperature T and temperature T. So both containers will have same volume and present at same temperature. Since the masses may differ, that's why the pressure of the gas is PA and pressure of this gas is PB. Now what we are doing, we are placing these two gases in one container with same volume. The new container volume is also same. That is V. The temperature is same. Now what happened? A molecule, these are A molecules. Let it be B molecules. So whatever the molecules that are present here are brings here. Whatever the molecules that are present are brings here. So both the molecules are kept in one container of same volume at same temperature. Now the pressure is increased naturally. The content of the substance present in that vessel is doubled, approximately doubled. Now the total pressure exerted by this gas molecules P is equal to PA plus PB. This PA is exerted by these gas molecules A, and PB is exerted by gas molecules B. So in a gaseous mixture, the pressure exerted by one component molecules alone is said to be partial pressure of that gas. Here, two non-reacting gases, A and B, are present in the second case in one container. Gas A molecules will exert some pressure, gas B molecules will exert some pressure. So the pressure which was exerted by gas A molecules alone is considered as partial pressure. And gas molecule, the pressure exerted by gas B molecules alone is said to be partial pressure of B. So the total pressure of the gaseous mixture P is equal to PA plus PB. This is Dalton's law. We have a proof there, separate proof we have in individually we have done. Now we are going to prove this with the help of kinetic gas equation. According to kinetic gas equation, PV is equal to 1/3 mn c square. 1/3 mn c square. Now let us apply this kinetic gas equation for two samples of gases. This is gas A, this is gas B. So gas A, gas B, both have same volume, they occupied same volume, same temperature, they are at same temperature. The pressure exerted by this sample is PA and pressure exerted by this sample is PB. And number of molecules are NA and number of molecules are NB. And velocity, RMS velocity is CA and these RMS velocity is CB. Because only volume and temperatures are same. Since the number of molecules is same, pressure and RMS velocities are also different. Now, for this gas, if you apply this formula for this gas, PAV is equal to 1/3 MA NA CA square. For PB, second gas, PBV is equal to 1/3 MA N, sorry, MB NB CB square. So now the partial pressure of this gas, we can write it as PA is equal to 1 by MN C1 square by V, and PB is equal to MB NB C square by V. Now if we keep these two gases in one container, then total pressure exerted by these gas molecules P is equal to, because according to kinetic molecular theory of gases, the influence of one gas molecules or the presence of one gas molecules will not affect the pressure exerted by the other gas molecules, because there will be no attractive or repulsive forces that exist among the gas molecules. So total pressure of the gas will be 1/3 MA NA CA square by V plus 1/3 MB NB CB square by V. But 1/3 MA NA CA square is equal to PA. 1/3 MB NB C square is equal to PB. Therefore, P is equal to PA plus PB. This is known as Dalton's law of partial pressures. Another task is to prove Graham's law of diffusion. Graham's law of diffusion. Graham's law of diffusion. According to Graham's law of diffusion, the rate of diffusion at constant temperature and pressures, the rate of diffusion of a given mass of gas is directly proportional to 1 by root D. That means rate of diffusion of a given gas is directly proportional to, square root of its density. This is Graham's law. If two gases at same conditions of temperature and pressures are considered, then the rates are R1 and R2 and densities are D1 and D2, then Graham's law can be written as R1 by R2 is equal to root of D2 by D1. This is another form of Graham's law. Now we have to prove this Graham's law with the help of kinetic gas equation. According to kinetic gas equation, PV is equal to 1/3 MN C square. PV is equal to 1/3 MN C square. Or we can write it as P is equal to 1/3 M N by V into C square. M is the mass of the gas. N is the number of molecules. So M into N is the total mass of the gas and V is the volume occupied by the gas. Mass by volume is nothing but density. So this expression can be written as P is equal to 1/3 dC square, where D is the density. MN by V, MN by V is equal to density D. So, when we are comparing, if two gases are taking, then P1 is equal to 1/3 D1 C1 square and P2 is equal to 1/3 D2 C2 square. When two gases are at same conditions of temperature and pressures, then P1 is equal to P2. When those pressures and temperatures are same, P1 is equal to P2. In such cases, 1/3 D1 C1 square is equal to 1/3 D2 C2 square, or D1 C1 square is equal to D2 C2 square, or you can write it as C1 square by C2 square is equal to D2 by T1, or C1 by C2 is nothing but root of D2 by T1, where C is the RMS velocity. RMS velocity, rate is directly proportional to velocity. So C1 by C2 is nothing but R1 by R2. Therefore, it is R1 by R2 is root of T2 by D1. This is the form of Graham's law of diffusion. So by this way, all the gas laws which we discussed earlier independently can be proved with the help of kinetic gas equation.